Greetings, fellow Whovians. Whovian Queen here. Welcome back to another episode of review. And today, we're going to be looking at The Empty Child. So, here we go. The Doctor and Rose follow a time-traveling metal cylinder to London during the Blitz of World War II. Landing about a month after the cylinder, the Doctor tries to track it, while Rose discovers a young boy wearing a gas mask on a nearby roof. Rose climbs a nearby rope, but she realizes too late that the rope is the tethering cable of a barrage balloon and is carried off the ground. Captain Jack Harkness, a former time agent from the future posing as a Royal Air Force officer, rescues Rose with his camouflaged spaceship before Rose falls from the balloon. Jack mistakes Rose for a potential customer of an object that he is willing to sell. Rose plays along, but insists she needs to discuss the matter with her partner before buying. Meanwhile, the Doctor returns to the TARDIS to find its phone ringing, despite caution from Nancy, a young woman nearby, not to answer it. He does, only to find the voice of a child asking, "Are you my mummy?" He follows Nancy to a house left empty from the recent air raid sirens, where Nancy and some orphaned children eat a meal abandoned by the homeowners. The Doctor tries to learn more from Nancy, but the boy in the gas mask knocks at the door. Nancy orders the children to leave by the back entrance and warns the Doctor not to touch the boy. The Doctor opens the door anyway, but the child is gone. The Doctor catches up to Nancy and convinces her to give him more information. Nancy reveals that she knew the cylinder fell near a nearby hospital, and its appearance is tied to the boy. The Doctor arrives at the hospital and discovers several patients wearing gas masks fused to their bodies. Dr. Constantine explains that Jamie, Nancy's brother, was the first patient with the symptom. Suddenly, Constantine changes it into another gas mask-wearing person, and the other patients all rise to start chasing the Doctor. Rose and Jack arrive and quickly escape with the Doctor. The Doctor forces Jack to admit that the crashed cylinder is just a Chilla medical ship. The three are trapped in a room as the converted patients converge on them, all asking, "Are you my mummy?" Nancy, who had returned to the home to get more food, is also cornered by Jamie, the boy, as he reaches out to her. Bom, bom, bom! So anyway, that's kind of an interesting way to end on a cliffhanger. So yeah, anyway, let's look at the production of this episode. This episode had the working title World War II. Early versions of the script quoted as this episode's title as being An Empty Child. This is a reference to An Unearthly Child, the very first episode of Doctor Who. The episode's television listings information and the DVD cover also mentioned that London is being terrorized by an unearthly child. Location filming took place at the Barry Tourist Railway. Barry Island and its now demolished Butlins Holiday Camp had previously been the filming location of the Seven Doctor serial Delta and the Bannerman. Sound after Constantine's skull cracking as his face changed into a gas mask was considered too horrific in its full form by the production team and was cut before broadcast. However, writer Stephen Moffat claims on the DVD commentary to this episode that the sound was discussed but never put on. According to the Doctor Who Confidential episode Fear Factor, the effect was added in the version of the episode presented on the complete first series box set. Unlike previous episodes, the next episode trailers were shown after the end credits instead of immediately preceding them, possibly a reaction to comments after Aliens of London about having the cliffhanger for that episode spoiled. This trend is continued for most two-part stories in the new series. Captain Jack's line explaining the nanogenes was not audible in either the original or repeat broadcasts on CBC television in Canada. It was also removed from the UK TV Gold and US Sci-Fi Channel broadcasts, although the lines were still present in subtitles. This adds some confusion to Rose's next line, "Well, tell them thanks." The reason for this change is unknown. Frequently in this episode, Rose makes references to the Star Trek character Mr. Spock. This is the first televised Doctor Who story to make a direct reference to Star Trek. Although there have been previous references in the Doctor Who magazine, comic strip, and original novels. Writer Stephen Moffat says in the DVD commentary for this episode that the Doctor's reply to Rose, asking him what she should call him, Doctor Who, was originally going to be, "I'd rather have Doctor Who than Star Trek. a metafictional dig at the latter program. The Chula ships are named after Chula, an Indian/Bangladeshi fusion restaurant in Hammersmith, London, where the writers celebrated and discussed their briefs on the scripts they were to write for the season after being commissioned by Russell T. Davies. This meeting was videotaped and is available on the DVD release of Doctor Who, the complete first series. Nice. So overall, I think this episode is kind of interesting, and again, it's another two-parter, but hey, let's hope that the second part is going to be better than the first. So overall, I give The Empty Child 4 Sonic Screwdrivers out of 5. Well, hope you liked that review, and if you did, be sure to like, share, subscribe, and if you haven't already, ring the bell so you'll be notified when I upload videos. And if you want to see me make better videos, then please support me on Patreon. I will put a link to it down in the description box below. So until then, this is Hoovy and Queen saying, oh my giddy aunt! Anyway, sorry, that was a little premature of me. So anyway, tune in next week as we take a look at The Doctor Dances. Okay, now, this is Hoovy and Queen saying, oh my giddy aunt! When I say run, run! I'm a recipient of the neutron flow. Would you like a chili, baby? Fantastic! Allons-y! Geronimo! Bow ties are cool, fesses are cool, and Stetsons are cool.